In this video, we're building a simplified on-demand pressurized water system for your RV, for your camper, for your van, for your off-grid tiny home. Now this is part two, so if you haven't seen part one, click on the card above and it'll take you there. Otherwise, let's continue on. So here's our next setup for the pump. So one of the first things you want to do is check to see which way your water is flowing. There's always a mark somewhere on this one. See right there, there's an arrow that tells you that water's running that way. If you remember, it comes with two each of these, two threaded fittings and two hose barb fittings. We're going to use one of each. The one that's going to the sink, I've got this 30 inch, I didn't need 30 inch, but half inch FIP to half inch FIP, both ends are the same. I went ahead and got stainless, I just like it. This is going to be permanent. This pump does put out a good bit of pressure, so it's also freeze resistant. I just thought it was a good way to go. So we'll need to put the pipe tape on here. And this simply screws on here, and then the other end simply screws right on under the sink to the cold water fitting. Now this part over here is going to be a bit more temporary, but we're going to use the hose barb fitting on this one. And this pipe is inside diameter a half inch. I also got the reinforced again, didn't need to because this isn't going to be pressurized, but this will go over this, and again another hose clamp. So the other end of this is going to go into our temporary water tank. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and I'm going to cut this top part off. Here's another little thing with your pipe thread. You want to wrap it around in this direction such that when you screw this on, so we're going to screw that on to the right, that it goes with the flow of the tape, not against it. If you're screwing it against the tape, it's going to buckle up and bend up. So, and this is the direction I go in. I guess if you're looking at it from this way, it would be clockwise. And so you'll want to do this not when it's attached here because you could break the plastic. So what I've done is I've hand tightened this as much as I can because I don't want to bust this plastic fitting. And so then we'll crank it on and it'll probably leak a little, and I'll just keep tightening just a little bit. All right, so now that my tubing is out of its warm bath, it's much more relaxed. And so here we have it. Now when you put these on, put the tubing all the way up to the end and put the clamp in the middle. Don't put the clamp all the way up here or all here. Try to get it right in the middle. Again, this one's not going to be pressurized, so the tightness isn't as big a factor. So you want to do as much work as you can outside of underneath the kitchen sink because it's not fun to do it underneath there. So once we get this mounted, then all I have to do is just I take this, plug it into these cool fittings, make sure it's all the way in, just push that down, and it's done. Same. All right, heading back under the sink. I've mounted it on the back wall to kind of test it out. You can see here I plugged in that water line. That just goes right up in here and screws to that fitting there. And then I've got my intake line going up and over to where the water tank will be. But the problem is this sticks out and it may not fit. So I need to put my refrigerator in here on its slide out and see if it's going to be able to go all the way back in. Otherwise, I've got to find another place. I tell you what, this build is absolutely amazing. Just the blind luck of tolerances, and I shouldn't say this out loud. You know, our first tolerance was up here at the drain line, right? That's just a light right there. The next tolerance was the water lines, and there's actually about a half inch right here where the water line's clear. I can tie this one up a little bit. And reaching around back for the pump, there's about another half to a 3/4 inch clearance. So when we try the slide, the slide works perfect. If you'd like to know how to make these slides, I'll put a card right here above. You can click on it. These are really easy to make, much easier than I really thought it would be. And in that video, I mentioned about putting the travel locks in, and here's the pin I was mentioning about. You just drill a hole right down through there. This is a pin. It's got a little button on the bottom there. And you can just leave it partly out and go back and forth, and then when you're ready to travel, just push the rest of the way down and it's locked in solid. And then I have this little lock over here that just spins around and it locks the pantry slide out in. So simple, easy, does the job. All right, it's time to do another test before we get the water tank set up. I put some zip ties in to hold everything in place. Looks pretty good. So if you've been subscribed to my channel, you've heard the story about this little wire here. So when the MAV was built, they put this wire in the wall, and it was not accessible to anybody. They put it in really just for me, I think. So when I was taking the walls down, I found this wire, and there was a note attached to it. And what's really cool is that they even put a note to it
and it says power source 12 volt DC 20 amps plus minus constant hot. I never really did check to see if it was hot because it might have gotten disconnected or never was connected, but that's one reason why I wanted to put my electrical box somewhere back in here is because I would have access to 20 amps always hot. So I'm going to use this. I did just now check it. Again, everything's just really working out. I am so jinxing myself. So I did a quick little test and the pump did come on. So since we've got this, now I haven't wired it up and we'll do a proper switch and plug and all that stuff. But I just want to test and see where my water leaks are because I am expecting a leak right here. I really hope we don't have one here. That could be a problem. And there shouldn't be one up above because that's a metal on metal fitting. So I've got my water line over here stuck in my tank here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get in there and give that thing a little power. I just want to see what's going to happen. So it's priming. Oop, there's water. We got a water leak here. Not so far. Not so far. Very cool. You know, I like this pump. It doesn't make, it's really quite quiet. I know I'm pretty close to it. Man, that's awesome. I'm so happy. Let's turn it off. Oops. Turn it off. Nice. The pump stops nicely. Drain works great. Works really good. All right, let's turn on just a little bit of water. So it still does that kind of thump thump thumpy thing, but it's not loud. I think when I have the refrigerator in front of it, the doors closed, and some soft goods and all in here, I think it'll be even quieter. Everything
seems to be going really well. I'm gonna keep checking it for leaks, let it run a little bit, make sure there's nothing gonna be happening slow behind the scenes. Oops, I see some water here. I don't know where that came from. So I did find one slight flaw that's gonna need to be dealt with. If you have the cold water valve open and you accidentally open the hot water valve, only while that one's open, if you happen to open this one, it combines and the water feeds back through here and comes out down here. So I need to try and figure out, maybe I'll visit the nice people at Lowe's, how to get a something here that's a dummy one, or put a line on here and crimp it off so that water can't come out here.
All right, so I did go down to Lowe's and got a half inch FIP pipe cap, and I'll put the tape on it and we'll put it on just the hot water until eventually I get the hot water heater put in.
Since that was metal on metal, I put it on pretty tight, got my wrench and tightened that down real good. So that should take care of our back pressure problem.
So I built this slide out here for mostly clothing and dressing. So in the morning for dressing, I've got my shirts. I just put them up there. I've got my pants in this bin and just put them up there. And then I have access to t-shirts, socks, underwear, a lot of little things. And this is also where I've allowed storage for my water tank. I've kind of put this in here to keep it in place. And so now the water line kind of comes up and over from the water pump down in here. I need to figure out how to fasten it a little better here and figure out how to cut the line. But also something I need to do, I had a brilliant idea last night. Over here we have a pump for suction. And what that is it goes to a suction pump that is back behind the wall here. And so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go in there and cut the wire to that and bring that wire over to the pump. So then I don't have to worry about wiring into that other wire right now, and I'll already have a pump built in, so that's gonna be great. Just come up here, hit the suction pump, and then that'll turn on the water pump, and then it'll be on demand. So that's gonna simplify things a lot, except I've got to go dig under here and find out where to cut that wire. All right, so I found my suction pump back here. Found my connector right here, snipped it, and there's my wires. So I like using these crimp connectors here. They're color-coded, so this one is blue, and so you get you a nice pair of wire cutters and crimpers. You put the blue in the blue, then you just slide the wire in there and crimp it on. A little more challenging. I've got to crawl in this little hole and crimp this one on there. There's very little room to work. Okay, and then once you've got them all crimped, give them a nice tug. Make sure they don't come out. They're not going to come undone. And so that job's done. I really didn't have anything in my arsenal for tying down the wire, so I just put in a little screw here and zip tied, and that's gonna keep the wires up and out of the way. All right, so back on the other side, I fished my wires through, connected them up, And so the moment of truth now is, let's throw the switch and see if we have power. Yep. Heard the pump kick on. Let's let the pressure off. All right, let's try that again. Yes. We are good. We are good to go. All right, now we got power. This is awesome, and that was pretty simple.
So here we have our water tank in place, and I found out that I did need to bungee it down, not really because it was moving, but because of the pressure from this pipe, which is really rigid. So I just clipped it over the top, and then I put a screw in, and to the point where this is not going to come off, and I'll just undo it here when I need to change it out. So now what also I found was the tube, when I was pushing it in, the tube, which I zip-tied back there on the wall so we don't have any pressure on the water pump line, the line going to the water pump. So what I did is I put a little bungee. So what I did is I attached a bungee here and screwed that to a board up here. And how I did that bungee up there is I got one of these small bungee cords with a clip here. And then I took my pliers here, and then I squeezed this right here real small, just to the size where a screw could fit through it and not come out. So one thing I like about these bins is they come in different sizes. This is a 2.5 gallon one, and they come in smaller sizes like this one. And I'll put the links below to these. But I have a lot, the reason I'm doing this way is I have a lot of bin space in outside, so I can have a bunch of these 2.5 gallon ones and just swap it out when I need to. So I took one of the tops and I grabbed hold of it with my pliers like this. And then I got my 1-inch drill bit, and I went in here and carefully drilled this out, which splits things apart like this. It's a little mangled. You can see it kind of comes out, but that's okay. We need a little air venting. So you end up with a two-piece cap that looks like this. And then I'm going to screw that onto here. And then we will put our water line into there. And it all goes back in here and gets bungeed back in. So one thing you'll see here is that hose is always going to seem to not get to the bottom. No matter where you put it, it moves around and curls around. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to fix that. Okay, so what I've done here is I've taken just some standard half-inch PVC water line, and I cut a small piece with these cutters here, which also works great for cutting the hose too. And then I use the hairdryer. You can use hot water. Just get this end heated up and then just push the pipe in there. It'll stay in. And what this does, you don't need a whole lot of pipe. It'll just kind of depend on your water tank and just kind of try it out. So then I feed this back through. And then once that's in there, you can see, even though it may move around, it keeps it from curling up and not getting to the bottom of the tank. Bungeed everything back together. I've got it in the tank. You can see it just stays there, and so let's push it in and see if it stays in place. Stays put. The bungee up there is working. So here we go. That. Back. Nothing gets crimped. Everything stays in place. And our water feed stays where it's supposed to be. I love it. I love it when a plan comes together. It's time to check out our finished project and put it all together. I've filled up our water tank here, push in the slide, close up our cabinet doors, go over here, and we'll turn on our pump, which is pretty cool. It even has a light. And I apologize for the noise in the back room. That's rain. It has been raining nonstop for 3 days. All right, so we'll turn it on. Even when it's doing the low speed, it's not a loud thumping, but you can really control the pressure here. 1 Love it, love it, love it. You know, we take having a sink for granted, and it looks so simple that people don't really appreciate everything that goes into making it work. So this is kind of an abbreviated system. You'll probably want to build something else, but you kind of get an idea for bits and pieces you might want to use. So if you found this video helpful, please hit the like and the subscribe. That helps me out. And join me in the next video where we're going to come up with some other project.